a gatekeeper, a miraculous healer. A Reiki practitioner, an actress, a comedian, a dancer, a pianist, an artist, an entertainer, a scientist, a mystic, a psychic reader, a traveler, a dream interpreter, a savant, an indigo starseed, a demonologist, a dream interpreter, a sage, and last but not least, I am the CEO of my family's business, Royal Phoenix Rising. Welcome.
Educational school systems.
14 the false conditions, beliefs, and ideologies of which prepare them to spend the rest of their lives enslaved within the matrix, working for entities that serve the ultimate underworld entity that has persuaded the world to believe that he is godlike and righteous, and Lucifer is Satan, who represents wickedness. This entity has succeeded for decades and millennia with this deceit. Many wonder how this has been possible. For this question alone, allow me to take you all down the rabbit hole of the human brain. My imagination is going like, it just going off, man. Y'all watch when I get my gadgets and shit. Alright, because I'm gonna take y'all on some real mind trips, okay? My imagination's like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I know, you know. Okay, let me be going. The brain is a complex organ with billions of cells called neurons. Through each neuron travels shockwave frequency volt, exchanging thousands of bits of information per second. If you silence your thoughts, the sound of the shockwave frequency volt will be able to be heard. If you focus in on the sound of the frequencies, you will be able to translate the frequencies into the human comprehension and understanding. Society has been conditioned and programmed since the stage of an infant to think illogically and backwards. Let's take a look, for instance, when we speak about the conscious mind, which many humans use during their day-to-day activities. The average human being uses a part of their brains of which has been programmed to function within a restrictive, illusionary, imaginary brain cage of which limits their brains to properly see past the veil that has been placed upon the actual conscious mind, which is known as the frontal lobe. The frontal lobe is located near the front of the head, under the front skull bones, near the forehead. The frontal lobe is part of the brain's cerebral cortex. Individually, the paired lobes are known as the left and the right cortex. The two sides of the brain largely controls operation of on the opposite side of the brain, of the body. The frontal lobe is no exception. The left lobe affects the muscles on the right side of the body. Similarly, the right frontal lobe controls muscles on the left side of the body. This can also determine how the body is affected, by a brain injury. For far too long, we have been taught to believe that the conscious mind is the subconscious mind, and the subconscious mind is the conscious mind. Based on scientific facts and common sense, the conscious mind 24/7 from the second the brain begins development, from the early stages of the embryo's existence. The brain of the embryo's development technically begins during the third week of its existence. The cells that rapidly multiply form what is known as the neural plate. This structured development folds in on itself to become the neural tube, which later gives rise to the forebrain, the unibrain, the hindbrain, and the spinal cord. The moment the embryo brain begins to form, the DNA of the embryo begins to work simultaneously with the brain. The DNA begins to send the brain thousands of bits of information, which is stored better from its previous lifetime. This data will later be stored within the Akashic records, which is located within the frontal lobe cortex of the human brain. This is an image of the human brain in its seven chakras. As you all can see, here we have the crown chakra. Here we have the third eye chakra. Then we have the third chakra, which is the throat chakra. Moving down to the fourth chakra, which is the heart chakra, which is located in the middle of the brain. Then we have the solar plexus chakra, the sacral chakra, and the root chakra. The frontal lobe is in the beginning of the human brain. It's located in the beginning of the human brain, as you all can see. Not sure where they've gotten their information, but I would just say, from my own personal life experiences, the subconscious mind has always been active, is always activated 24/7, right? So if the conscious mind is activated 24/7 around the clock, non-stop, isn't it logical, or doesn't it make sense that the subconscious mind would be, in fact, the conscious mind? And the conscious mind of which we, humanity, use daily during our day-to-day activities in order to survive, in order to thrive, in order to evolve. What we have been taught to believe is our conscious mind is technically our conscious mind that has been reprogrammed to think and conditioned to think how to think. What to think, when to think, how to be, how to act, how to walk, how to speak. It is our conscious mind that the adversary has tricked the world to believe is our unconscious mind, so that they can program us, humanity, to reprogram and enslave us within our own mindsets and within our own brains.
To raise, to rise.
on its movements and gives us instructions on what to do during our day-to-day activities. The mind also gives the body instructions on how to heal itself. How is this possible? The seven chakras of the human brain, of which works in an alignment with the seven main chakras of the human body. Each chakra works simultaneously with the seven main chakras of the human body. Going deeper into this, it's not a theory, these are facts. Going deeper into these facts, allow me to take you deeper into the rabbit hole of understanding how the brain heals the human body.
Quite simple. The in-between spaces
essence of the flower of life of which Terrence Howard spoke about are the vibration, are the wave congregations of which allows the allows humanity to coexist within other dimensions while living simultaneously in the past, present, and future. For those who are not aware of Terrence Howard's breakdown of the sacred geometry, mathematical equation of the flower of life discoveries. Based on his discoveries, the wave congregations of which he spoke about, which exist within the in-between spaces of the flower of life, they form, they multiply, and they expand within them, within their self. Within itself. This expansion forms unknown dimensions that the human race has yet to tap into.
Sacred